Here is Israel.
דודי רפן אף אישי נחשפה לבית אחר מלכי, לבית אחר מלכי. נורא אל נורא, נורא אל נורא, נזר בגבורה.
Hi everyone, shalom. We are Orphaned Land from Israel. We exist for 23 years now. Started right here in this neighborhood. Me and Uri, we formed the band as teenagers. We were 16 years old. Our career is very long and very interesting. We played in more than 40 countries already. We did 5 albums, 1 DVD. And you can easily say that Orphaned Land members are the most popular Israelis among Arabs, despite politics, despite the situation of the Middle East. I would say that it happened because I think that our subjects, since we were teenagers, have always dealt with stuff like the macro of the Middle East more than our personal lives or ex-girlfriend or stories of our own. We always dealt with motifs from the Middle East. That mean that we used motifs from the 3 monotheistic religions, with Jewish prayers or Muslim muezzin or Christianity, you know, in some kind of a ways. But it was not in a way of being missionaries or religious. It was just in a way of, there is a strong heritage for these religions in that country, in the Holy Land, and this is a part of the country. Using that with heavy metal, it was a perfect blend for us to reflect what life in Israel and the Middle East means. We played in more than 40 countries so far. This year we're gonna play in many new countries like Australia, China.
Costa Rica, Lithuania.
We did Costa Rica just a while ago. We did South America. We played all over Europe, all over the States. The biggest dream would be to go to Arab countries in which we cannot go because we hold Israeli passports. But we have many fans in Egypt. We have many fans in Syria. And it's amazing to see how, when it comes to the common people, there's no problem at all. The amazing thing is to see the people of Iran coming to our concerts in Turkey.
Yeah, we just met one of them last time we've been in.
Yeah, you see, they're secular. They don't care about history. They know that the Jews are from this region. We both have a strong heritage and culture, and we live in harmony with them. It's a big brainwash of politicians that divided us to be the way we are. But according to history, Jews, Arabs, Iranians, Syrians, Druze, they are all Semites. That means that we come from the same tree, that we come from the same father, that we are one big unhappy family. But we can change it. And I'm not naive. I mean, I don't think we can change the world with heavy metal music, but we can definitely set an example and show that it's possible and give an inspiration, whether if it is for people or for politicians. The first stereotype was always that we are slaughtering cats or worshipping Satan. That was the first stereotype because people tend to judge by a very narrow-minded ways, you know, they just tend to judge based on nothing, basically. And but I think that we, with Orphaned Land, we killed any stereotype that there is for metalheads, because it might be an absurd that a metal band succeeded to do much more than politicians. I mean, we're playing in Turkey, we're Israelis playing on a Muslim country, and people are coming from Egypt, from Iran, from Syria, from Lebanon. They come all the way, they do all the travel to Turkey to see an Israeli band. They sing with us in Hebrew. I don't know any politician, author, documentary maker, I don't know anyone you can name. I don't know anyone who has succeeded to achieve that achievement. And we did it with music, we did it without kissing any butt, never expressed any political opinion. No one knows if we are right-wing or left-wing. And we like to keep it that way because we believe that the algorithm that music succeeds to do is to create a new algorithm who is above politics. And when we are on stage, that utopia is actually happening where Arabs and Israelis are singing together the same song. For a few moments, there's no conflict. For a few moments, this is again the two sons of Abraham without any conflict, just as we are in history. Because according to history, Israelis and Arabs, they are brothers. It's politics that made everything to be so complicated and to create such conflicts between two. But our songs, our subjects, if an Arab listens to it or if an Israeli listens to it, they can easily identify themselves in that. And that's what makes it probably to be as good as it is.
Actually, if you look at our friend list on Facebook, you will see that I think 70 or 60% of the people are from all around the Middle East, you know, from Muslim countries and such. And thanks to the internet, actually, it could happen because our music cannot be sold in Muslim countries around. So they only can find out about us through the internet. So this kind of technology helped us in a way.
Yeah, I mean, internet, it's a global village that made everything to be easier because you can see easily that our fans on Facebook, they greet us for Jewish holidays. We greet them for Muslim holidays. We are the smallest example of how easy it should be. We didn't share a land with Arabs. We share a tour bus with Arabs. And when music is the subject, it's not a problem. And I really think that Israel is a great example. Of course, there are problems, but Israel is a great example of how to embrace all religions and how to welcome all cultures. And I think that the Arabs that are living in Israel as a minority, they have a great life, if you ask me. And of course, nothing is perfect. Always things can be better. But I'm proud to be a part of an Israeli band. And I'm proud that we have succeeded to achieve so much with Arabs and Muslims. And what I could really wish is that our leaders, our politicians, our shepherds, they should take an example. If we can do it, there's no doubt that they can do it. They can and should do it even much better and much bigger than we do it. People tend to stop me and Uri on the street and always tell us, you know what, heavy metal is not our cup of tea, but we're very proud of what you're doing and we like what you're doing. You're bringing honor. You're creating good news when every time the news about Israel is negative or about politics, you bring a positive story. And they're feeling proud. They're calling us Israel's pride in many ways. Gaava Israelit.
Israel.